It's Professor Dave. Let's look at big numbers.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
When we introduced the concepts of addition and subtraction, we were looking at very small numbers. 2 apples plus 3 apples is clearly 5 apples, which can be verified by simply counting the 5 apples. But sometimes we need to do arithmetic with very large numbers, where counting becomes impractical. When this is the case, we must rely on computation to give us answers. Let's say one market sold 1,293 apples today, while another market sold 2,614. How many were sold in total? We definitely don't want to count all those apples, or we will be here all night. Instead, we can calculate the sum. So how can we do this exactly? Well, if we are using a pen and paper, the convention we have come up with is to place one number over the other, with a plus symbol and a line below. This signifies that we are adding the two numbers together, and the sum will be listed below this line. We must make sure that the numbers are lined up in such a way that the place values are in perfect correspondence. The units place goes with the units place, the tens with the tens, and so forth. Now the math is very easy because we just add 2 digits together at a time, starting with the units place. 3 plus 4 is 7, so we put a 7 here. With the tens place, it's a little trickier because 9 plus 1 is 10, and we can't put 10 here as we want a single digit. So instead, we must realize that we can put a 0 if we then increase the hundreds place by 1, signified by adding a 1 on top. This is called carrying the 1, and it works because 10 tens are the same as 100. We do this any time we go over the capacity of a certain place to report value. So in the sum, we have a 0 for the tens place, and we move on to the hundreds place. The 1 that we carried, plus 2 plus 6, gives us 9 for the hundreds place, and then 1 plus 2 is 3. 3,907 apples were sold today between the two markets. This works the same way for subtraction. Let's say one market vendor started with 473 apples and sold 286. How many does that vendor have left? Let's arrange these numbers just as we did for addition, making sure to put the larger number on top. Now, starting with the units place, we have 3 minus 6. That's not going to work, so what if we borrow one of the tens from the tens place? If we cross out this 7 and put a 6 instead, we've borrowed 10 units that we can give to the units place. That means we can now do 13 minus 6, which is 7. Now, in the tens place, we have 6 minus 8. Again, this won't work, but if we borrow one of the hundreds from the hundreds place, 400 becomes 300, and we've borrowed 10 tens that we can use for the tens place. This means it's like we have 16 tens minus 8 tens. That gives us 8 for the tens place. Lastly, 3 minus 2 is 1. The vendor has 187 apples left to sell tomorrow. So now we have the basic algorithm for adding and subtracting larger numbers. We can use this method to add long lists of numbers beyond just 2 at a time. Say we want to add all of these numbers together, 17, 22, 11, 34, and 46. We could add 2 together, and then a third, and so forth. But that's time-consuming and becomes increasingly impractical the longer the list gets. Instead, let's use the method we just learned to add them all together at once. In the units place, 7 plus 2 plus 1 plus 4 plus 6 is 20. So let's put a 0 in the units place and carry a 2 to the top of the tens column. Now, the 2 we carried, plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 4, gives us 13, and there's no hundreds place to carry anything, so we just write 13, which gives us 130 as the sum. And now we have a basic algorithm for adding and subtracting large numbers. Let's check comprehension.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.